And Friday, so before you abandon your home and build an ark, we figured we might talk to our friend Roy Spencer from Perma-Seal and see what you can do to prevent flooding during these torrential downpours. Roy, thanks for joining us. Appreciate it.
Well, thank you, Dan. Good morning, Amy. But be of help. It's been a long time since we had a good storm, so we've been very busy and grateful for the busy, but sorry if people are having problems.
So give us some sort of best practices homeowners should consider to prevent flooding. Obviously, prevention is ideal, and some of what Perma-Seal can do for homeowners.
Yeah, I'm happy to. Flooding is the worst thing that can happen because I've experienced it in my home and my business, and it's just an awful thing to experience, and the damages are, incalculable and stuff. So it's something you really want to avoid. And most floods actually come from pump failure. All sump pumps fail, and sometimes it's due to power outage. Sometimes it's due to just the mechanical, the motor fails, the switch fails, the discharge line gets clogged. There's all kinds of reasons, but they all result in the same thing, a catastrophe for you to clean up down there. So at Perma-Seal, we have a lot of solutions for that. Of course, we have backup pumps that can work off a battery if there is a power outage. We also have a new device that we've invented called the Basement Defender that will actually test your pump and your pumps, your backup and your primary pump, every day at 8 o'clock a.m., electronically test it, and then send you an alert if there's any problems. So it really gives you peace of mind going through your day. So that's the number one thing. Avoid flooding is to make sure your pumps are working, and nobody has time to check it every day, but with the Basement Defender, you don't have to do that.
What's the best thing to do if there's water in your crawl space?
Well, if you have water any place, the first thing is be safe. Don't go in there. Don't go into standing water unless you're certain the electrical is turned off down there, because you don't want to, turn this into a health safety issue. So, be safe. I would call for help. It's not something the average homeowner is ready to do, is pump that water out. So we have crews available to come out and pump that water out, and then we can assess the problem. In it's a crawl space or a basement, what you want to do is, first of all, be safe. Secondly, call for help, get that basement pumped out, and then, start moving things to high ground. It's going to rain again tomorrow and things like that. So if you have carpet or things that are wet, just go ahead and pull them out, either throw them out or let them dry out, but just don't let it sit there. So I know everybody's very busy, including ourselves, but we've got over 100 trucks on the road, and every one of those trucks have pumps, so we really try to respond to people in emergency systems. The other reason for flooding, I should mention, is sometimes it's a sewer backup due to the municipal sewers being overloaded. We got heard a lot about that, and that's not something we can could just come and do and replace your pump. Your pump's not going to keep up with the city sewers, but there is a solution for that. We have sewer backup systems that can isolate you and protect you from even municipal sewer backup. So, again, no reason to live with a flood. There's a cause for it, and there's a solution for it.
All right, so the sump pumps, sewer backups. What about just the ceiling around windows and other places around the home where water can incur? How often should those seals be checked and that sort of thing?
Yeah, well, thanks, Dan, for reminding me that another source of flooding sometimes is the window wells. There's drains in most window wells, but a lot of times those drains aren't maintained or they're about the size of a sink strainer, so it doesn't take much to clog them up, and homeowners don't realize, A, they're there, or B, that's their responsibility to clean those drains. So sometimes the only thing standing between you and inches of water in your basement is just cleaning those drains around your window well. So, again, it's something that homeowners should make a regular practice when they're outside is to dig around in the window well. It might be leaves, might be an inch or two of silt that need to be cleaned out, but window wells need to be cleaned out. So that's a source of flooding. Of course, seepage, cracks and things, that's what we do every day, and you don't want to live with any seepage either. And again, if you're having water in your basement at all, there's a problem, and it can be fixed. So I would say you don't live with water in your upstairs bedroom or your living room. You shouldn't live with any water in your basement either.
All right. So how can our listeners get a hold of you and Perma-Seal if they want to do some of that preventative work or if they need more urgent response.
Yeah, either way, the number's the same. 800-421-SEAL. That's 800-421-7325. Or they can go on the net, of course, at permaseal.net. And again, please be patient. You know, a lot of people are having problems right now, thousands of people. And we're the biggest. We are the best. We have over 50 certified inspectors out there working night and day trying to get out and help people. And like I mentioned, we have over 100 trucks on the road. So, you know, I would say don't panic, but also don't delay. You know, give us a call. We'll get you on the schedule and we'll get to you as soon as possible.
All right. He's our guy who keeps you dry, Roy Spencer, Perma-Seal. Thanks so much for joining us. Appreciate it.
I like that, Dan.
Yeah, the guy who keeps you dry.
Yeah,
there's
you can
your
use that in
slogan.
A jingle. Yeah, you want me to sing that in a jingle?
I'll sing it, Roy. I'll sing it.
I've got to change all my business cards now. Thank you very much.
All right. And the guy who likes to keep you dry, Roy Spencer, joined us on our turnkey.pro answer line.
The more you listen, the more you'll know. This is Chicago's Morning Answer. Morning Answer on AM 560, The Answer.
Signature Bank.